Hello everybody, welcome to another Honkai Star Rail video. Before you, I have a tier list with a few characters that at some point or another people thought was going to come to the game. A lot of people thought that these characters would be added to the game, and in fact some of these characters may still be added to the game in the future, just not now, just not yet. But we're going to go over, I figured this might be a little fun idea. I'm going to do a tier list of these characters in order of which I would like to see them enter the game. So let's start off. I'm not sure what a lot of these people's names are from the destruction thing. From the Annihilation Gang, that's what it is. From the Annihilation Gang, I don't know who their names are for a few of them. I know Duke Inferno, of course, everyone knows Duke Inferno. But if these characters were revealed, I forgot their names. But I'm just going to call them, you know, whatever. So this girl, the puppet girl, whenever I first saw her, and she had this big puppet behind her, it gave me very, very big Svarog vibes, and I really like Clara and Svarog's dynamic. And yeah, how she was basically a puppet, and then she like died and fell over, but then like she like, I don't know, was like revived and, you know, held back up by her like big evil cape or whatever it is behind her. I thought that was really, really cool. She was probably my favorite or second favorite character in the entire Annihilation Gang by just straight up design. I thought she was super cool. So I'm going to put her in S tier. This girl with the big sombrero. It's not a sombrero, but I don't know what kind of hat that is. I don't know the name of that hat. But with the big white hat and the white suit, I thought that this was probably the second, definitely the hottest, the second coolest character in the entire Annihilation Gang, in my opinion. I thought that she looked extremely badass, and I would really, really like to see this become a character in the future, just along with Clara 2.0. Now, this character right here was also in the Annihilation Gang. A lot of people really, really liked her. I'm not a fan of like the spiky teeth that much. I tolerated on Boot Hill, but I, as you guys see, I did not pull for Boot Hill. So, yeah. But I don't know. I don't really like it that much, but she is definitely a super hot character. Unfortunately, super hotness being all you have doesn't really get you anywhere on this list. It doesn't get you very far. Get you above D tier for sure, but I'm going to put her at C tier. This dude, I actually think he's super cool with his instrument. I think this is probably a lot of people's least favorite looking character of the entire thing. I don't like how much people kind of shat on this guy. I think he's really cool. Like the whole bass, like being a song dude or someone who would fight with music, like a bard in a way, would be really, really cool. Of course, we have Robin, but she kind of sings with her voice. She doesn't really, you know, fight you with an instrument of any sort. So I think that this would be a really cool addition to the game, but I am going to put him in C tier, but definitely above this character here. Duke Inferno, obviously the leader. I think he's really, really cool. He has a suit on. He looks very different. He's not the standard e-boy male. He is like a fiery ram with a monocle in a big suit. I think he looks extremely badass, and I'm going to be putting him in the A tier. Kukulia, now that we're out of the Annihilation Gang, we got three more left. Kukulia, people have always wanted Kukulia to become a playable character. And I think that this was before we got like the endgame zone boss for the Luofu. And then, I don't know, because like, and then like the musical guy at the end of Penicone, I don't know. Definitely, I couldn't see a way where this character or that other character would ever become playable characters, because they're always in their huge form and they're in their really big form. But I think Kukulia could easily do it. I think she would be really cool. Maybe she would be the first unit that can actually summon other units on the board, how she summons the two ice thingies. I think that would be really, really cool if she could be like the first unit that summons units for your team. And also her ultimate would be like her going up into her big form and raining like the icicles down on your team, down on the enemy team. I mean, I think that'd be really cool. Kukulia definitely still has definitely a spot that she could fill in the game. So I'm going to put Kukulia probably just because I like Bellabog so much and I kind of miss the insanely really like the insanely good story in early days of, Bellabog and just how cool of a character Kukulia was for a while and how peak that that story was. Definitely going to put her in the A tier, but probably below these two. Just in terms of design, I think that these three are insanely, insanely good. And Kukulia being right below them, but still in A tier, definitely not a hit against Kukulia. Now, this may come as a surprise to people, but I've actually wanted... I have been so vocal about how much I want Skrullum in the game since the moment Ro was added, right? Because, of course, now we're getting Sam, you know, and we sort of have, like, Svarog, but in, like, the form of Clara. And we have Sam in, like, the form of Firefly, though, but I don't think Firefly is ever on the field, right? It's always Sam in his suit, in the suit, so... Yeah. Before all of that, before we even knew Sam was ever even going to come to the game, right, we had Skrullum in the game, and he was a part of a few pretty big storylines. And I've always wondered why he never came to the game. And then other people say, oh, he's going to come to the game at some point, probably, but just as a 4-star. Why do we want that? Why do we want... He's been such a really... insanely good and influential character in the entire story or throughout the story at various points. I really, really love his design and everything. I think he is super badass and I've wanted him since the moment that I saw him. Because I tried to say this before, but yeah, at a point before we knew Sam was coming, this was the only like character that wasn't just a dude or a girl. It's like a fully fledged, not even someone in a mech, a fully fledged robot with like its own thought. Like it's a fully sentient robot. He's just a really cool character. And in my opinion, due to how much I've wanted him for so long, he is S tier. If they release him as a 4-star, like him in a 5-star form, S tier. Him in a 4-star form, D tier. I'd rather you not even honestly bring his ass into the game. You're just gonna do a 4-star. Like, I think it's so stupid. I think that'd be so stupid. Anyway, let's get to Sunday. Sunday, I believe, is going to be the sole holder downer of the B tier. And I think, actually, I am going to be a little bit more ruthless here. I think that this character is D tier. There wasn't really anything besides just the boobies, I guess, about this character that made me, like, want her to be in the game. But yeah, let's go to Sunday. Sunday is for sure, I want him in the game. I don't think I will ever complain if he never enters the game. I don't care that much about Sunday, but I do believe that he is important enough of a character, especially in, you know, the high points of Penacony, that he definitely should be in the game. Like, he should be in the game. So I'm going to put him in B tier. And that's going to be my tier list. Thank you all for watching. This is just a little bit of a fun tier list. Of course, I want Bomb Bomb in here, you know, Bomb Bomb, S tier, even above Skrullum. Let me play Bomb Bomb. Come on. Think about it. Now, thank you all for watching. If you like the video, like it. If you dislike it, dislike it. But anyways, have a wonderful day. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And yeah, peace.